Man, you have no idea how bad I want to just put on a Lady Gaga video and just play it and be all like, what you gonna do now, sucker?
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the Merritt Brainstorming Hangout. I'm Tom Merritt. That's Brian Brushwood. And this is Jackie Hearn. Hey,
there's no wrong answer in brainstorming. I'm just
putting
out.
That's right. You're already spitballing.
Talking about piracy.
Before you ever got on. So we need to make sure that the peoples who need to know that we're live. And I always forget where you're supposed to find those. I think it automatically posts to Google+. So you can look there. If you're hearing it, though, you don't need to, do you?
What's your agenda, Tom?
My agenda tonight is to make sure that everybody who is kind enough, and by the way, you all are crazy awesome with the amount of offers to help, from small to actual large. So to make sure that everybody who has an offer to help, make sure that I get that and keep it straight. That's why Jackie's here. She's amazing. And then also to just brainstorm, like, okay, I've got to make new shows. I've got one in the works with Scott Johnson that we've got a pretty good idea of what we want to do with that. Welcome to hear ideas about that, too. But Brian Brushwood and I are going to do some kind of cord cutting something. You know, we have that survey out, like, what do you like about frame rate? Tell us what you don't like about frame rate, too, obviously. And then we'll also daily tech news show. I'm going to do some kind of daily tech news. I can't stop myself. So we want to hang out about that as well.
You have a problem, Tom. This compulsion to report the daily news. The fact that I can wake up because my kids wake me up at 6 a.m. and see that you're already populating docs, that's you got to stop.
I'm populating a doc right now.
Doc, see, I told you have a problem.
Okay, so are we getting... do we have anybody who sees us? We have Sunbun has a link. Is that the right link? Good. That is the right... Oh. That's not the right link. Yes, it is the right link. I thought it was not the right link because I saw myself saying something else, but that's because there's a delay. I have a problem, says Brian. Echo.
Tom, if you want to put that link in the chat here, I'm kind of confused where it is. I will send it out to everybody in the IRC.
It is in the... I got it from Sunbun in the IRC.
Oh, okay.
So there it is again.
Great.
And if you want to send it out to the email list.
Sounds good. I will.
This is a brainstorm.
Yeah, we'll go ahead and
you are going to see sausage, and you're going to see it made. I didn't mean to say sausage right when Sebastian showed up on screen. I apologize.
Yeah.
Welcome, Sebastian.
At least you didn't say diarrhea of vomit.
I appreciate
yes.
that.
One of my favorite things that was said on frame rate today. MailChimp's hard.
Yes,
why do they make it so hard? Actually, it's not that hard, but for sending out like a quick, hey, everybody, we're alive.
I'm doing it. I'm going to send it to that list that was created. I think there's about 1,000, close to 1,000 now on that list.
So while I send to the other list, Brian.
Yeah, Brian, entertain us.
What do you want from a cord cutting show?
Seems like we should have one segment. We should call it the top issue, and then we should have another top issue, and then we should have box tops, and then we should call it the flowing river. then we should have
the bit rate.
There you go. then we should have a segment called Shut Up, We're Not Listening to You. where they can send in their letters.
Email, by the way.
We just tell them to stuff it.
I am picking a holiday-themed email template right now.
What?
Wait, why are you picking... okay, hold on.
I've got an email list.
I didn't think you were serious that I needed to fill time. So
No,
I know you're serious now. So now I'm going to take care of this.
So now you're just going to stumble around and go, well, the thing is
so hard.
The stuff is that we want to do a thing.
Nope. Here we go.
About scan
right
lines.
Here. Wait.
Okay. What do you think? Is this a good format, everybody? Just
great. It's a great show.
People kind of distracted trying to find wolves.
I swear to God, Dob, right there. That's your avatar from now on.
Wise Ass Dob Productions.
You forgot the one that Justin posted earlier today.
Which one was that?
The one of Tom.
Let me see if I can find the link. The one from the show?
Let me see if I can find the link.
Jeez.
Okay. Will you make guest appearances on TWiT? It's fair to ask some questions like that, by the way. As I said off the top, I don't want to spend a lot of time talking about what happened. What happened happened, and it's all up there, and I'm fine. Everything's fine, okay? Will I make guest appearances on TWiT? Of course. If they asked me to be on TWiT, who would turn down being on TWiT? That's ridiculous. So thank you, Kenneth. What's the channel name for the IRC chat? T2T2 is also the channel name.
Yeah, or I guess if you just go to t2t2.eu, then you're there.
Although in my colloquy, I had to enter the channel name t2t2
some reason. T2t2. Well, that explains why nobody's talking in it.
What's the channel name for the IRC chat? Done.
Sensor guy wants to get in the chat. Do you want to have him in here?
Yeah, I think I actually know his name well enough that you don't have to give it to me.
JC Bobbitt was asking the same thing.
Yeah, I tried to find him. You guys don't see. Oh, sorry. That's Blame Cheeto.
Yeah, that's the one.
I'm so not America. Jackie.
Yes.
Hey, Jackie, can you in the Google Plus chat, the direct chat,
okay,
just send me JC and Jaime's names.
Okay.
Neither one of them are coming up, and I know them. I just don't know why they're not coming up.
JC Bobbitt is hard to find for some reason.
Yeah.
I've had trouble with it.
Maybe that's the problem. Is I didn't.
You're not doing real work. I'm gonna put this out to someone that there needs to be like a looping animation of telepathic Tom, and it's just this. It'd be like, hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's me, telepathic Tom. I know you're wondering how I know what you're thinking, but it's all here. Oh wait, let me see. Then it cuts. And we're like, if it was looping, I could be telepathic Tom at all times and control your very soul with my blink.
Was I wearing the same clothes? No, it's a different clothes. Same jacket though.
There we go. There's like a good 8 minutes of just looping material here. It's me, telepathic Tom. People, I'm here for you, with my mind. And Catcher's mask.
You're making it so difficult to work.
Sorry. Look, you asked me to fill air, I fill air. It's me, telepathic Tom. I'm the king of filling air.
Okay, I really do want ideas.
Okay,
Jose asks, would you consider a TNT competitor? Not necessarily at the same time. I don't want to compete with TNT any more than TNT wanted to compete with Buzz Out Loud. But will I do daily something? Yeah, that's what I'm trying to figure out. What is it that you guys want? What's the hole that needs to be filled? And I know they're going to change what they do, too. So that will make room for everybody. Can you talk about new plans with Scott Johnson? So you want me to pull a Johnson on Scott Johnson? Is that what you're saying? Okay. JC, I see that.
You can at least drop some juicy tidbits.
Yeah, I think we've just about settled on a name, and I think Frog Pants fans are going to love the name. I think we've also settled on one segment that's going to be in the show that people are going to love. I don't want to say what they are because we haven't quite both said, yes, this is for sure, or we would have posted it. That's the thing. Once we decide stuff, I will post it. I'm not going to post it before we decide because we might change our mind. That's
so Scott Johnson. Scott Johnson didn't make you sign an NDA then?
No. Scott, are you kidding me?
I like the fact that the very
Paul Swickard is here, by the way, and he's cackling now because he's like, NDA, Scott. He's here to demonstrate that it's not a green screen.
Wait, hold on. Who is that? Who is that? Did you say Patrick?
It's real.
Paul.
Like, real.
Oh, Paul. Okay.
And Janko. trying JC Bobbitt again. Oh, yeah, there you go. You need to use periods when you want to put that in. Don't blink. Blink and you're dead. Okay. Yay. Mike Lipson, are you looking to join other networks or starting your own? Yes. I'm looking at everything. All of the things. And I will pick from them. We need to have a show that is similar to TNT, but maybe not so scripted. The only thing that's really scripted in TNT is the news views, and that's because they're headlines. So we kind of want it
regimented. You know, one of the things people seem to like about some of your other shows are, you know, for example, on the one end of the spectrum, you have Tech News Today, which was very on rails. You always knew you were inches away from the next item, whereas on the flip side, you know, you have East Meets West, which is, you know, Vi.
Yeah. It's one text editor that I don't use, and more of an Emacs guy.
Yeah. Actually, I was thinking of Vi Hart, the mathematician and teacher on YouTube. She works for Khan Academy now.
Yeah, I like Vi. Vi, short for Violet. Is that right?
Violence. Strangely enough, little known fact, her name is Violence Hart.
Hey Tom, did you get the link to the responses for the questions that we tweeted out?
No, can you PM that? I got the link to the form, but I never did see the responses.
All right, do you want me to PM it to you in the chat room or in Google Plus?
In the chat room.
Thank you, Sebastian.
Tom, do you want me to go ahead and call up some of the frame rate responses to just give you some tidbits of what people
did? Yeah, that's a great idea. Of those?
Hi there, folks.
Hello. So we have you. We have some members of Chat Realm joining us to represent Chat Realm.
And we also tweeted out that link to ask Tom a question to the IRC chat. So as people have been gathering in the last hour, they've been adding questions to that.
Do I need to? Is it something I should be looking at or no? Should I be ashamed of it?
If you want to look at it,
I'll link it in the chat.
Oh, here. Have you read all these questions, Tom?
No, I have not.
Okay. Curtis Larocque wants to know, how much do I love you? He does give you the following hint. The answer is all of the love.
Well, that was quick.
Well, what's the answer?
Next time, take a little more time.
Trick question. The answer is seven.
Seven? Yeah. I think that's about right.
Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, TV show or movie? Go.
TV show.
Really? I like the movie.
No, I'm not saying I hated the movie. You guys told me to pick. I had to pick.
Okay, here we go. This is a great one. From what I understand, you're a sports fan. Have you thought about doing some sort of sports talk radio style podcast where you don't tell us the news, but you give us entertaining analysis and speculation about tech stories in the news? Something like what PTI or what Mike and Mike do. And I was wondering, you know, on sports stations, you have that trend of posting up the rundown of what the story is, so you know you see a literal countdown in many of them to get you on to the next thing. Have you thought about doing something like that?
Yes, in fact, we thought about that for TNT at one time, especially when I had to move down here, because we thought it might help with the distance. The only sports shows other than FSL Tonight, a fine sports show, is that I've considered doing as like a fantasy sports show off and on. But even that, I just think it's a stretch too far. I enjoy fantasy sports, but I don't think I want to throw myself far enough into it to actually make a decent show. And if I can't make a decent show, I don't want to do it.
If you were to do that show, who would be your co-host?
Justin Robert.
Yeah. Probably. Here's an interesting one. Full disclosure, my friend Tom's wife works at YouTube. But Bob McBob wants to know, could you leverage your any inside connections you may have, I'll restate it for him, with the YouTube studios to do a daily tech show on YouTube Live?
No, I answered Bob in the chat room. Probably not.
Yeah. That seems like that would be I'll tell you what, man. YouTube don't play around. They want value for their money. Either value in that you're already a super famous person, or they need to know for a fact that you'll bring numbers.
Yeah, and the other thing about it is they're not really set up for daily. They are the kind of place that really just wants to be special productions. People who come in and use the studio, up their game, make their stuff look good, and they're really oriented towards that. You don't see they can't just say like, okay, come in and use this studio forever, which a daily news show kind of needs. So you saw Young Turks go in there and use them temporarily while they were in between studios, and it's great for that kind of thing. But I don't think I would be able to make use of that as a permanent home. Maybe for special events or something like that, if we wanted to have like Cord Cutters Week or you know, just some kind of stunt thing maybe. Eric says, now that Molly is also unemployed, do you think it's possible you guys getting together for something daily or weekly? I don't know. Everybody's saying that. They're saying that about Veronica and everything. All I can say is all the options are on the table. Every option you can think about is going to be on the table. I haven't got anything decided. When I do, you'll know.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Tom,
Mitt Romney.
If I can break in, binders full of Chad them. Would like to join as well. If you
yeah,
can.
I just invited him.
All right, sounds good.
Did
Sorry.
He get it? Tell him if he didn't sure. get it, I'll re-invite him.
Okay.
Keep reposting the forum on the chat. I'm not actually reading the chat room now. I'm reading the forums that you guys are doing. Ooh, this is interesting. Well, nope, I'm not going to read that.
Here, I'm going to answer this one. Genta says there's no official death notice of frame rate anywhere. We actually announced it on the show today. The dogs are not happy about it. But yeah, it's we talked about it on frame rate. Boy, the mailman comes late.
Man, I'd so many of these. First of all, if you're gonna ask a question, understand that we are obligated. We have an I say we. First of all, I when I say we, I'm only talking about the situation where Framley. Tom has an obligation to you know, not talk about the behind the scenes stuff. That's what it means to have propriety. So please don't ask these kind of troll baity questions. Phrase things appropriately, I guess is what I'm trying to say.
I'm trying to speak over my dogs, is what I'm trying to say. It really wasn't a mailman. Gee, really? All right. Got Brian who says, will you keep your signature puns and segues, or does TWiT own those too?
Good question. Here's an actually really, really good question. Rocketude wants to know, are you interested in doing more video shows in addition to Sword and Laser, or would you be okay with mostly audio? Now, this is something you and I have kind of almost argued about.
Yeah, which side am I on?
Well, you point out quite correctly, you were a staunch defender that the majority of your viewers and, I guess, of your consumers are audio, and you were making a case for you should focus on audio, whereas I felt like... Like, even if it's the option that you ignore, having the option of video, I think, is important, of knowing it's there.
Yeah, and I don't say no video. Video is harder. So it's just a matter of, is there a way to, is there a reason, is there a benefit to doing it for video that's like, oh, this really needs to be video because the consumer is going to get more out of that, or it needs to be video because it's, you know, going to make 12 times the money. But mostly I feel like you want to do a little video and a little audio of everything, because that's just the way it is. Whether it's a hangout video with the focus on audio, or whether it's a studio production video with the audio captured and then just relayed, those are kind of the two extremes, and it depends on the show.
Well, do you know if you're going to be live or not?
I will probably always at least do like a hangout or a Ustream or something live. I don't intend to create a network. I will say that. That is the least likely thing for me to do, because I see what it takes to run one. I'm, you know, maybe someday, but I want to focus on content. It's why I told CNET that I didn't want to be a bigger executive there, is that I want to focus on content. I just want to do content. And when you run a network, you can't focus as much on the content.
But to help, like, think of new shows, do you think that... the content would be focused on having a live interaction? Is that what you want to...
No, I think of it more as spy cam stuff. I mean, yes, live interaction, sure, like we're doing right now.
Right.
Exactly. I want to respond to the growing frustration among some of the audience by those who claim that frame rate was never the same after Scott Johnson left in 1992.
Yeah. Jaime, would you like to take that one?
Yeah, I'm sorry. It's Brian, I know, you know, we love you, but after Scott left, it just wasn't the same.
That's what I feel.
Hold on, I have to sign something.
He stands up and he goes.
So now that Tom's gone, what bad things
can you get out of? Right. Well, let's get to the meat of the issue.
Let's see. Nobody else is posting here. I guess I'll actually read the chat, which I said I wasn't going to do. Tom questions form. Kia thought that was funny.
So Brian, how cold is it in Austin? I heard it was like really, really bad.
Well, it was like 28 degrees over the weekend. I haven't been able to. I felt so stupid getting in a car and driving 20 minutes to get in the gym so I could walk inside, walk upstairs, sit down, and get on a pretend bicycle and play Civilization while I pedal for an hour.
That felt bad for you? Like you like
felt dumb. Like what's the point?
That's what most people aspire to go do workout,
I guess.
So Tom, was that the first shipment of review units for your new show?
It's just like the mail.
But I guess it's seven at night?
It's a new, yeah, seven at night. I guess it's a new mail carrier because the place I rent is split into a duplex. And she's like, is this the half or is that the... Because it's the number and a half and then the number that's full.
You have the not Polar Express, but Hogwarts Express level whatever in 3/4.
Yes, right.
Reference
exactly.
Would come to me.
9 3/4.
There you go. I thought that reference would come to me before I said it.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, exactly. So what were we saying before Jaime answered for me?
The question it was about whether or not you raped and murdered Scott Johnson in 1992.
No, I did not.
Okay. All right. Well,
I have a question, Tom. How can everyone reach you from now on? You're going to need like some sort of center place. And, you know, a lot of us have gone out and created different groups and things that to generate just contact information to help you. But where would you like everyone to center this?
You mean like contact info?
No, but like what's your... Okay, like... Everything is so spread out. Like, what is the best way for people to reach you?
Exactly.
TomMerritt.com is the best place to reach me. If you can hear me.
You can also send mail. Sawyer loves it.
To platform 9 3/4.
Yes.
Yeah, TomMerritt.com is the center. It's the place that is everything.
Here's a great question. Finally, we're getting some good questions. How would you feel about pitching a late night cable TV show? Maybe, you know, if you knew some people who knew some people at Revision 3 Discovery or whatever, would you consider? Because, I mean, you're right there in Los Angeles. Is that something you want to do, or do you feel like you belong on the internet?
I feel like I belong on the internet. Also, Twitter, Google Plus, as far as contact info. Some people in the chat room are like, what about Twitter? Yeah, of course. As far as a late night talk show, I would do a late night talk show on the internet, possibly. In fact, that's kind of the feel of the Scott Johnson thing, in a way. Even though you know it's not a daily. Let me tell you, daily's hard. Daily is not easy, and you know the compulsion for me to do daily tech news is just that. It's a compulsion. Otherwise, I would never recommend anyone ever do anything daily if they can avoid it.
That's what I was going to ask. If you were to still have the opportunity to do a daily show, though, would you do that, or are you trying to stick?
Yeah,
with
I'm gonna weekly? Do. I definitely want to do a daily tech news something, and I don't know what that means. But yeah, for sure.
Okay.
Well, I'll tell you what might be easier because here's the thing. God, I'm gonna sound like one of my favorite articles that sort of shaped what. became my magic show was I read an article, I want to say in Genie magazine, like 20 years ago from Teller. I think it was Teller, Penn and Teller. He said, don't let love be your guiding artistic force. If you let love be your guiding artistic force, the best you will be is a pale shadow of whatever it is you love. He said, instead, define what you hate and then be the opposite of those things, and you will end up being something totally new that will be precious and special and wonderful and all that stuff. So maybe it would be easier, Tom, for us to ask questions about what you wouldn't do and look at the periphery on there. So far, sounds like television's out. You don't want to do television. Is that right?
No, I wouldn't say I don't want to do television. They asked if I wanted to do a late-night talk show on television. I kind of think that that's impossible. I don't think that's something I'll have to deal with. If somebody said, hey, we'd like you to do a limited series and we'll shoot it over these couple months, yeah, I might do that. Depends on what it's about. If it's about something that I'm interested in and feel like I have something to contribute on. I don't want to just be a talking head, though, that's for sure. But I don't really want to talk about, like, me. I want to talk about shows. I want to talk about what folks want. Like,
okay.
I mean, I've already said, and a lot of people missed it, so it's worth reiterating. Brian and I are going to do a cord cutting show. I'm going to do some kind of daily tech something, and Scott Johnson and I have got a weekly that actually is more fleshed out. But we want to know, like, what do you guys want from that? What do you want from a tech news show? What do you want from a cord cutting show? And is there some glaring hole out there? Especially in the space of the things that we do, that you're like, gosh, I wish somebody were covering this aspect of it. And then there's also the side of it that Jackie was pointing out, like if you're somebody who's been saying, hey, I want to help, let her know in the chat room. She's keeping track of all that.
Would you consider doing an hourly show?
An hourly show.
I was actually pitched this earlier on Skype, so apologize to Oddmast. He wanted to do a indie video game show, sort of focused around Kickstarter. But how about, and you know, he wanted to focus it very much on video games, but Kickstarter and crowdfunding is a big thing. You think that some sort of beta version of hardware or crowdfunding show would be interesting?
I think it would be interesting. I'm not sure if that's something I want to dig into, at least as a whole thing. But yeah, I could totally see somebody doing a Kickstarter-oriented crowdfunding show where they just go through like some of the crazy things that are happening. In fact, there's a couple people doing that show. I've been interviewed for that kind of show before. And they're what they're doing is, what are the cool things that are out there? You know, what kinds of stuff should you look for as a consumer, as a backer, to be careful and to get the best rewards? And what kinds of stuff should you look for as a creator to make sure that you're getting the backing that you want? I think that's a great show.
You know what? You could also do a segment. I mean, whoever was to do this could. It would be great to see some accountability for the failures at Kickstarter. Like, who's the, you know, the turkey of the week? You could.
Yeah, do. Right. Yeah.
Say like, you know, thanks for taking 30 grand and flushing it down the toilet, jerks.
Bob McBob says he wants a 30 to 40 minute triangulation-like show with people you find interesting. Well, that's triangulation, though. I mean, I guess I might find slightly different interesting people. An interview show is not a bad idea, but I'd want it to be a different spin.
I miss Current Geek, and I remember you mentioning that geek culture was not a big TWiT thing, and it seems like now we have an opportunity.
Well, yes. For one thing, the geek culture stuff that has been tried on TWiT, both by myself and others, just never really has caught on. But there's also the problem with Current Geek, when Scott and I launched the weekly version, was we were hobbled by my CNET agreement, because that launched when I was still working at CNET, and I was not allowed to do any competing content. So we had to very assiduously avoid doing any technology stuff. Mm-hmm. Those shackles have been gone for a long time. So between those two facts... all options are on the table. That's all. But yeah, no, I think we could do a better version of that, I guess is what I'm saying, where we wouldn't have to like artificially ignore stuff, and I think that would help that show.
Tom, there are people in the chat asking whether, you know, how they can help. Do you want me to put something together that they can fill out?
Yeah. Do you mind? That'd be great.
Nope, it's done already.
Awesome.
We've been going through that the last few days as this group of us have been talking. Every time we say, you know, we need to do this, and someone says, it's already done. You know, it's amazing. I don't know where I would be right now if it wasn't for Chat Realm. It's the most amazing thing in the world.
I'll tell you what, though, you bring up a good point. That's the whole South Park Simpsons did it problem, where it's like... What's funny is, and I don't know, it's like, everybody's done everything, so there's nothing you can do about it, so there.
Wait, what are you saying? They're saying, like, somebody needs, like, I need a graphic done, but it's done. Not, I have an idea, and someone says, oh, but that's been done.
Oh, before. I thought that's what she was saying, because I was...
Yeah, pretty much, that, you know, while your brain was processing the idea, I already read your mind, and it's done.
I think it's a time travel deal where you go in the future and set it up for when you need it. I think that's what's going on right there.
I'm gonna plow through some of these questions.
JC Calhoun requests more interviews with authors outside of the scope of Sword and Laser, and I don't know if that means he's looking for a Sword and Laser type format, but outside of fantasy and science fiction, maybe anything from history nonfictions. You can get somebody like a Malcolm Gladwell or something.
Yeah, that's an interesting idea. Like, take that, not format necessarily, but take that idea of, hey, let's have a book club. I mean, The Verge kind of does that. They have a book club that's just books that they think people who are interested in The Verge would find interesting. That's a cool idea, is to just say, like, all right, let's do author interviews. Let's do reading with generally kind of widen the net. In other words, not just novels, not just science fiction and fantasy, but geeky people, both fiction and nonfiction.
You also have a comment from someone from Australia who says, could you keep in mind the shows that you do in the future, having them later in the afternoon or in a way that the time zones aren't so...
Yeah, I'm glad you brought that up. The answer is that it doesn't matter what time I pick, it's going to be wrong for somebody. And in fact, there really isn't a time that's better for anybody, even in the United States. And we, you know, when we were at 2:30 and then later 3:00 in the afternoon, we had all kinds of people saying, this is a horrible time for the show, you need to move it to the morning. And then when we moved it to the morning, we got a whole bunch of people saying it's a horrible time for a show, you need to move it back to the afternoon. And so if we put it at a time that works for Australia, that's great for Australians, but then the UK people start to complain, or the East Coast people start to complain. But I pointed that out, that even just the US people, when it's not even about being awake or being convenient, it's just about like, oh, that doesn't work for me. I feel like, especially with news shows, particularly daily news shows, there's no wrong or right time. It's always going to be fresh for 24 hours until the next thing comes along. So it's not that I won't take that into account. I don't think there's an answer that's not going to leave somebody out, you know?
Tom, there's a great pitch for a show here. Somebody says, how about a Craigslist mobile tech help show? Like Call for Help, but you go fix computers for people on Craigslist and try not to get murdered.
Or raped. Or both.
That last part's really, really important. That's interesting. That's a lot of work. Field production like that is always a lot of work. So that's probably not something I would do right out the gate. But that's an interesting. That's an interesting pitch. That's a good idea. You should go do that. Whoever's pitching that, that's a great idea. Jose Gomez says, I think a news show more like BOL and less like TNT would be awesome. More relaxed with fun segments and more shoot the breeze with friends kind of deal. That's a great question. Do you guys want it to be, let's assume that Tech News Today is going to become more of a breaking news thing. I've heard Leo say that. And let's assume that what I do is going to continue to be analysis and digest oriented. These are the important things you need to know. Do you want it to be tighter, efficient, like give me the facts with some punchy, fun talk? Or do you want it to be that more laid back, hey, take your time, give me the facts, but then give me lots of conversation and lots of talking around the issues, et cetera, or something totally different.
I think people tune in to watch the people and that they know and they like, and they like the interaction. So, and I think in that sense, the news is like the setting for that. So I think more conversation would be great. I would enjoy it, especially because there is going to be a TNT going on somewhere, and you don't want to compete directly.
Yeah, but what if they start doing more conversation? I guess I don't know. Yeah, but that's okay.
Well, yeah.
I like this question from Brett, who asked, I dig a 30 to 60 minute show on science and tech history. Any plans on that? Maybe. I've actually pitched to TWiT the idea of doing a weekly tech history show at various points. It's never happened. We've talked about bringing back the daily tech history, and that never happened. Hold on. Let me finish just a second. Sure. I probably, all things being equal and I'm having enough time, probably will put out an audio-only daily tech history podcast to go with the posts that I do at TomMerritt.com. And just to promote the book, if nothing else. They'll be short and just throw them out there. I would like to do kind of a weekly history show with good guests and stuff like that. Go ahead, Brian.
Can I tell you something that you're going to think is a joke, but I'm hoping this is a brain worm that will
How is this not different than all of our conversations?
Okay, this time there's not a dog facing towards you.
Got it.
As I said. Okay.
Well, wait, no, there is.
But, now, this is going to sound like a joke, but in all seriousness, what if you were to tell the stories of tech history and channel Dan Carlin while you did it?
Yes.
Dan Carlin.
Hardcore tech history?
What's that?
Yep.
Yeah, like do hardcore history, but about tech history. Because you got to understand, like, there's a whole generation of people. To you, it's old hat, the story of Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak. I would love to hear a 3-hour, beginning to end, Dan Carlin-style story of you weaving all the threads of you tell the story of as you understand it, as you then synthesize it, because you've read all the books, and bringing it up and getting to this moment and then say, you know, some people think it's this, some people think it's that. Me, I think it's somewhere in the, you know, and then you go in your own thread or whatever, and you make comparisons to make it relevant to today. I would go nuts for that.
Yep.
A buck That's a right. show. It's all we ask.
No, you ask for a Bitcoin a show. That's all you can afford.
A Bitcoin a show. Just $1,000 a show. That's all we ask. We only need 10 Bitcoins a show to keep on the air. Come on, folks. Open up your encrypted wallets. I like that idea. That's a cool idea. All ideas are on the table, by the way. But yeah.
I'm sorry, Tom. Someone actually mentioned something that I know that has come up quite a lot. Is will you and Brian consider a show that is a spoiler zone show? Because I know that you guys talked about doing sort of a book club type thing, which I thought was great. Like on the you were about to start on The Shield. Would you consider doing that?
Well, yes. We would consider doing it. Yeah, Brian. I don't know how much you want to. I mean, yeah, we love doing spoilers and stuff.
Okay. Well, I mean, we'll just say part of the reason. Let's say we have considered in the past breaking out the spoiler zone to its own feed, but we couldn't figure out a way to make it work technically. We think that there wasn't a compelling. We didn't have enough in us to make it its own completely different show, but we think we have some ideas to how we can expand the spoiler zone, which I guess already implies a thing, and I shouldn't have said that much. So,
well, no, it's fine. I don't mind. I mean, the thing we don't want to say is we're going to do this when we haven't actually decided, right? We've got all kinds of ideas that we're like, is this a good idea? And then the next time we talk, we've both changed our mind on certain things. There are other things, like we're going to do a show, that are not varying. So, yeah, I mean, spoiler zone definitely is something we want to do, and we're considering doing. We're just trying to figure out the best way to do it. That's all. God.
Like, just then I was afraid I'd stepped over the line, and I just wanted to go like, hey, everyone.
That dog is America, by the way.
Yes.
Fun voice. Hey, Tom, Snowshoe has a good question. Can I pay you in bottles of hard cider?
Yes, I answered him in the chat room, and of course.
Okay, good.
Yes, absolutely.
Sure.
I believe Snow Shoes, a female. She's a lassie.
Yes.
Bottles of hard cider from Alaska, even better. Mike, I have been knocking some of your questions out because you're asking a lot of questions. That's okay. I don't want you to be offended. I'm trying to make sure there's room for everybody. But he says, I would enjoy a tech show that isn't so much about covering what's new, but highlights things that you find interesting and goes into depth on them. No one better at breaking down complex topics. That's kind of the Dan Carlin idea too, huh?
Yes. I also like this idea, and maybe this could fold into my pitch for you doing a Dan Carlin Hardcore History of Tech. How about a show that highlights a misunderstood topic, maybe tech, maybe not, and tries to clear up misconceptions? So I get, you know what? I would listen to you talk for 3 hours just about the history of Snopes.com and of the clarification of urban legends on the internet and misinformation and clarification of information. I would dig that.
See, it was Ernest O. Lawrence who delivered his 1939 Nobel Prize in Physics banquet speech in Berkeley, California. At the time, it was 1940. World War II is going on. So instead of the usual Sweden, he needed to raise funds for his cyclotron research, so he decided to stay in Berkeley.
I'm sorry.
He did. Awesome. He did get his prize in the end, and that's hardcore Goosebumps. 20 seconds tech history.
See, you got to put in more than 20 seconds. You got
I only put in 2 seconds of opening to a random page research. So you know, it's there's a relation there. There's a
I just got goosebumps. I would pay a Bitcoin for that.
That may be a rash. You might want to have that checked out.
Yeah. Hey, speaking of a rash, I've got to rash out of here and get some work done. But I'm going to call my work done here because I gave you the best idea. Hardcore History of Tech, I'd pay you more than $1 a show, and that's all I ask.
Wow. Okay, so I've got $2 a show already.
Well, I said more than $1.
$1.50.
All right, Tom, I'll check you later, man.
Hey, thanks, man.
Bye, guys.
Die in a fire. Some of your best TNT shows were when there was active and sincere debating. It would be great to do a daily news with PTI-style dynamic, pardon the interruption-style dynamic. As we mentioned earlier, we definitely kicked that idea around. That's not a bad idea. Do chat room like that? The PTI style for tech roundtable? Seemed to like the hardcore history idea.
Yep.
I think the hardcore history idea is a winner.
You know what, though? Dan Carlin talks about how much research, how much time it takes him to do that stuff. So you really got to set aside the time. I'm not saying that I shouldn't do that. But it's the kind of thing that sounds a lot easier than it ends up being.
Yeah, but you don't have to do a four-hour show.
Right. And I wouldn't. I don't think I could. That guy is insane. I love those shows. I'm glad he does them.
They're awesome.
Yeah.
They're just completely amazing, but yeah, 4 hours.
Rasputin in the chat room says, what's the first order of business? How long will you be off the air, do you think? I don't intend to be off the air really at all. You know, hopefully Scott and I launch pretty quickly after the first of the year. Tell you what, if you go back and look at my time between Buzz Out Loud and Tech News Today, I didn't stop doing Tech News in the 2 weeks I was off between them. I went to Ustream, and I hung out with people in the chat room, and I talked about Tech News for like a half hour as sort of a beta version of the show. So if nothing else, you're going to get something like that from me. I can't stop myself. I won't be missing. I won't be gone. The thing is, I got to make sure that I get certain things right to be able to do them well.
Right.
Tom, Curtis B. in the chat says, any thoughts to doing in-depth specials on a specific topic like you've done in the past? I don't know if you could make it a scheduled show, but those were awesome.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that's a possibility for sure. That's a good idea. It depends on who I'm working with and what I'm doing, obviously. But yeah, and that kind of fits in with those kind of Dan Carlin-ish episodes that people are talking about, doesn't it? Yeah, it's a good idea. Thanks, Curtis.
Also, Tom, I posted in our chat, there's a link that has all the responses from people. Somebody gathered that. I'm not sure who did, but whoever you are, you're amazing, because everybody in chat realm is absolutely amazing. There's a list of responses and comments from various members that I've put there if you wanted to run through those.
Where is it?
Oh, it's in the Google Hangout chat.
The Google Hangout chat? Just give me a
Any
second.
Any thoughts of doing a show with Eileen? Doctor Who?
Yeah, no.
Becky.
She won't let me. No, and she's also just ridiculously busy. Oh, cool. So what is your cool show idea? Free and cheap entertainment. That's what you're getting right now, if you consider it entertainment. I'd love to see something similar to what we're watching, but more of a review element, something that addresses new video media on the net that people might not know about. Okay. Yeah. That's an idea for like a breakout or a spin-off.
I like that also because, you know, now that we all have sort of access to the media and entertainment around the country, the world, more so than in the past, that, you know, it would be interesting to be able to talk about those. Well, you know, I don't know. A lot of them I personally access by using a VPN, but you know, there's a lot of extra sort of entertainment things that we've never been able to access before that a lot of us are doing today.
That's something that I think would be a good fan-fed segment where people kind of, I don't know, it'd be awesome if people did video reviews, but I know that's always harder for people to do. But even just sending emails like recommending stuff that they've found.
Have you watched The Black Mirror?
No, and I've had it recommended by a bunch of people.
You must watch that.
Well, what channel is it on in the U.S.?
It did just recently. Because
it just started. Yeah.
Yes, it just came to DirecTV.
Is it on the 101 channel on DirecTV or is it on?
I don't know. I will find out and I will send it to you. But I saw that story recently that it is now available in the U.S.
Hey, chat realm, I would like to remind you to go to tinyurl.com/helptommerritt and fill out what you think you can help out with. You don't have to, but if you feel like you want to help out and you have a specific skill set, jump in there and fill that out.
Yeah, let me talk a little bit about that, because that's you don't have to. You don't have to at all. Like, I know. I just can't help myself. Like, please, I don't want to feel like I'm out there saying, like, you all need to do all my work. But if you want to, and if you're like, gosh, no, I just really want to do this or that.
We're used to it.
Yeah. I know.
Yeah, we are used to it.
This trail for me, believe me. Actually, frame rate, too, to be honest. But, yeah, I'm going to need, and I will start posting, like, these are the things I need at certain points. But, yeah, I'll need show opens. I'll need music. I'll need segment bumpers. I'll probably need bandwidth at some point. I mean, I've always paid for the bandwidth here, so this is probably enough to get started, but, you know, it depends on what I do, whether I'll need more bandwidth or not. Extra cameras, a lighting person, video editing, posting, all of those things are possible things that I will need to figure out at some point.
And Tom, you know, I tweeted out the other day, I was like, to chat realm, I said we need a Rolodex. We need a Rolodex of chat realm and the resources. And you know, because everybody here, we have so many wonderful creative people in this group, and you know, everyone could kind of just post what their skill sets are, and you know, that's then you know who to go to, and not just you, but all of us.
Yeah, that's awesome. Is that something, Sebastian? Is that what you were talking about earlier?
Yeah, that's kind of what I had in mind. Jackie did kind of take it way further than I thought of, which is awesome. She did a great job.
Sorry.
No, it's fine. You did a fantastic job. You have quite a few people who are already wanting to help out. People who want to set up a website to do it, and that's great. You know, I just kind of put together this form, kind of get us started. You know, so that we know that we do have people that can help you out.
And where is that?
TinyURL.com/HelpTomMerritt.
There you go. Thank you.
Curtis B. asks, any thoughts on setting up a special Tom Merritt chat room where we can interact with the fans, listeners, regardless of the show?
You're in it, dude. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know if T2T2 is always going to be able to use, let us use this, but we'll have something. We'll come up with something. Because yeah, absolutely. That's most of my brain in there, all of you. So turn that off, and you'll actually notice it on Sword and Laser because we don't do it live, that I'm just not as smart.
Well, you know, Tom, I actually have a server that we could probably put it on specifically for chat if you want. That's where the Merritt Militia stuff is hosted right now.
Okay. Yeah.
We could put it in there
If you don't think that's a problem for you,
it's not a problem for me. I mean, I would need somebody else who knows more about it than I do, but hey, you know, I'm always willing to help out with that. That's not a problem.
Cool. That's awesome. Time to get your ham radio license, Gary. Gary P. Yeah. I actually probably should. You know, the funny thing is everybody's like, oh, you're going to have time now. And I actually have less time right now than I have ever had because I'm still spending 30, 35 hours a week on Tech News Today and, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 hours on Frame Rate during the day, and then just the various other things that I have to do, plus all the non-TWiT stuff like Sword and Laser, and actually mostly just Sword and Laser right now. Everything else I do is pretty seasonal, but yeah. So that's why I was like running into the chat room at 9:25 today because I was just actually mostly that was because of Sky News, I guess. But stuff I just feel like I'm always behind because I'm taking care of all this other stuff now suddenly.
Sure.
Yeah. I don't know.
Well, you've got us. I mean.
Yeah, you guys have made it so much better. I should take a moment actually to say that the support means a lot to me. It was a difficult weekend, and so the idea that I had that stream of you guys, you know, I didn't like the hating. There was some hating in there, and that did not make me feel better. But the folks who were just saying like, "Hey, we're behind you," the Team Tom stuff, all the Merritt Militia stuff, that was awesome. It really made me smile, and it helped out a lot. Thank you so much.
Oh no, and Tom, I tweeted this out once that, you know, we've had crappy days, and you know, watching your stuff makes it better. So I think you know, a little bit that we could take up our days and support you and stuff.
Yeah,
it was awesome.
Yes, please do that. there's always like when you hire an intern or a new person at work. And you're like, yeah, they can help, except then I have to take time to explain the thing. So there's certain things that, yeah, I could just outsource, and I will, and I have some of those. Right. Other things are just like, it's just a personal decision in some cases.
So. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, I've had this up here for a while. Drew was asking, do you have any plans to bring back Forecast? No. Are you, Xavier says, are you considering bringing back this thing? The internet needs a Tom and Molly show. It's a thing is not gone. Nope. Am I back? It's a thing is not gone. It's a thing is seasonal. To be able to do a full-time job and then have extra podcasts, one of the things I hit on with Scott and Molly was, what if we just do 12 episodes at a time? Then it's less trouble. We're not doing video. We're just going to do audio, and then we can actually do shows that we otherwise couldn't commit to. So we've done 2 seasons of 12 episodes of It's a Thing. We will do another. I can 92% guarantee it. We have no intention of not doing another season of that.
I got an idea.
All right.
That it's kind of a spin-off from Autopilot. For example, you guys got me watching Magnum all over again. and it would be interesting to go a little bit into, you know, those series and some shows that you might enjoy. You know, like
that was actually, you know, it's funny. Have I talked to you about this before? Because that was the original idea of Autopilot. We kind of worked backwards into Autopilot from that idea. because we realized, because our original idea, our very first idea for Autopilot was to do Star Trek and just have a series where we would just watch all the episodes of Star Trek, the original series. Then we'd watch the animated series. Then we'd watch the Next Generation. We'd just keep going. And then at one point, Scott and I were like, that's a lot of episodes, dude.
Yeah.
And it's going to always be Star Trek. And then there's people like Daryl and Mike out there and Ken Ray and all these people who know way more about Star Trek than we will ever possibly know in our lives. And we're like, what if we just talked about pilots instead? Anyway, so I'm not saying never. I still have this idea of doing Babylon 5 that way at some point.
You should.
But yeah, that's still kicking around. I'm glad you brought it up. Bassam wants to know if Brian and I would do a video game show. I'd appreciate a mid-30s age perspective on video games. It was called At the Controls. It was even less successful than Game On.
Yeah, I remember that.
I'm not... All ideas are on the table. But honestly, I suck at a video game show. Like,
that's too soon, Tom.
Yeah, At the Controls was fun. But when every week Glenn would be like, what have you been playing, Tom? And I was like, a mobile game?
Yeah.
And Warcraft?
No, I'm sorry. I had the control problem. Needed to die.
Should I get some more of these? Do you anticipate staying fully independent, working for someone, or some hybrid? All of those things. I can see all of those things. I think I'd probably like to stay independent. But
speaking of working with somebody, I think that IO9 is right up your alley. Have you thought like collaborating with them or something?
Yeah, well, we're on good terms with those guys. We talk to them every so often. We're gonna try. I hope to get Charlie Jane Anders on the Sword and Laser Video Author Guide show because she is a Hugo Award-winning author now.
Yeah.
And we love her. She writes some of the best stuff on the internet. So. At least that, and yeah, of course. We've chatted with Anna Lee here and there. That would be cool.
Love it would be awesome to have some sort of, kind of like the top five kind of thing, but like stories from IO9. Be awesome with you on.
Mookow says audio drama adaptations or original material. I mean, that's sort of the audiobooks, I guess. I would love to voice audio drama if people. I'm not sure. Again, I'm really bad at saying I can do things and overcommitting my time. But I would. It would be fun to do like acting in audio dramas for people. I've done a couple of them here and there, and it's been really cool.
Well, I just leaked that back into the chat that they can go to the tiny URL help Tom Merritt and list that if they need it.
Yeah.
Also, you know, the other thing is, I think this might be a question that some people would have is that, a lot of us came from to TWiT as fans from tech TV, screensavers, mm-hmm. and all that. Would you, and that splintered off with Revision 3. Have you talked to Revision 3 or what? I mean, I don't even know how that works these days now that Discovery.
No, I pretty much talking to everybody who will pick up a phone and listen to me. So yeah, if you can think of them, I've probably either emailed them or already talked to them. In most cases, I guess that's not really true, but yeah, of course. That like I said, all the options are on the table.
Tom, Xanthus.
There they are. They're right here.
I think that's how you say it. I think it's Xanthus. How many webcast podcast shows would you be interested in doing at one time?
As many as I'm doing right now. And one more called whatever Scott and I call ours. I think I do too many already. So if I replace the Daily News and I replace Frame Rate, I gotta cut it out. But maybe I won't. Maybe I'll do something different.
Here's a good question.
Yeah, go ahead.
Can we crowdfund a new background studio for you in the new year? A break from the TWiT Mizen scene might be nice.
Mise en scene. Who is Flash?
No Twitter handle.
I've thought about that. I don't know. Probably. You don't need to give me anything for that specifically, but that could be part of the idea. Oh, I really love that fireplace. Don't you guys love the fireplace? I know it's bricky, but that's fine.
Cool.
That's not a bad thing.
Just move, Tom.
Yeah, right? It is a rental. But, you know, they say that, like, really stressful things can kill you, and the more big stressful things you have in life, the faster you'll die. We just moved. My wife changed jobs, and now I'm going to be changing jobs again all in a year. So I don't want to kill myself. I don't think I'm going to move if I don't have to. Please don't make me have to.
But if it doesn't kill you, it makes you stronger.
Whatever doesn't kill you weakens you for the final blow.
kill you, gets you XP.
I just want to address this from Bob Ford. He says, let us pay you back and join together and do a Kickstarter to help you till you get on your feet. It is the least we can do. You have enough fans to do it. Bob, I would never just do a Kickstarter to pay my bills or anything. I don't think they even allow you to do that.
I
just did a Kickstarter for Sword and Laser. I've done a Kickstarter for Ten State and for FSL Tonight and for Autopilot. So as you can imagine, that is definitely one of the things I'm considering for one, at least one, if not more, of the shows that I end up doing. Although, you know, I did talk to Justin Robert Young about just becoming a drunk.
Hey, there's job security in that.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the pay is horrible.
Yes,
the pay is horrible.
And the hours are long. Late work.
Late.
I think the hours get shorter when you're a drunk.
I guess so, right? No, you have to complain. Definitely as time goes on, those hours get shorter. You guys can throw me questions. Is there anyone else we should add into the hangout? We've got a few open slots too. We could.
You invited Scott earlier, right? Or Scott?
Justin's not available, I guess.
Yeah, I actually have not checked the list.
No, Justin's busy working, or he would have joined.
Right.
But if there's anyone you want to let in, actually there's one person I'm going to see if he's around.
Good.
From Chimera, any interest in a political or social issues show or segment, either tech impact focused or not?
That would be interesting, particularly with the NSA.
Yeah, maybe an issues or a policy type show. I guess that's along that same spectrum of those hardcore history specials that you were talking about earlier. That could be cool. I don't know if I'd want to go full on politics, just because that's a whole new topic area. And I generally do like to know what I'm talking about. And so, yeah, that's if it was like, you know, innovation, tech, science, policy, that could be cool.
People are asking to plug the chat room URL. It's t2t2.eu/IRC.
Oh, no, that came from SQ Freak. He's mentioning the other chat room, chat realm URL for the IRC. But I thought we moved it over just to make it, so if those of you that are in the chat realm chat, we kind of moved it over here to take the burden off of SQ Freak. Anyways, that's behind the scenes administrative stuff that's boring.
Oh, but if you are in chat realm, head over to t2t2.eu and join the t2t2 chat room.
Yeah.
You'll be glad you did.
What about a Reddit show? You could just read the most popular stories on Reddit. Maybe call it, I don't know.
Hey, Sperling. Ladies and gentlemen, Sperling Reich.
Hello.
From SQ.
Hello.
Chat room. Chat realm. We've got an echo coming in now from you.
I thought we moved it over just to make
I don't know if you're... I see you have headphones on. Sorry.
Yeah, we're getting a little bit of an echo.
That was my fault. Sorry.
Oh, it's gone now. Awesome. Are you still Showbiz Sandbox? Is that right?
Yes, I am. Showbiz Sandbox, Celluloid Junkie, and any one of a number of other outlets, box
office. I don't have a doc in front of me, and I still remembered.
Yeah, that's actually pretty good. Now, I don't know. I don't know how to do this whole Hangout thing, so I'll be honest. I don't know if I'm coming through video-wise or audio-wise. So
you're great.
Okay.
You look great, sound great. Yeah, you're doing it right.
As far as the Hangout goes, all you do is talk.
Yep. Ed says my other idea is some sort of 16 and pregnant show. I don't think I can do either of those, unfortunately.
Well, Mike, are you more interested in doing tech coverage, or are you interested in doing both tech and media and entertainment and, well, I guess books would fall into media, but...
Yeah, I mean, I think I want to stick in my subject zones that I've been, you know, getting good at over the years, and technology is in the center of that. But, you know, we've talked about history, we talked with tech history, talked about policy, especially tech policy. But yeah, you know, I do a book podcast, science fiction and fantasy, so it would make sense to consider branching out into doing like a broader book podcast. I could do, you know, because of frame rate, you know, there's the movie and TV ideas there. That space is, as you know, got a lot of attention on it. So you really have to know what you're talking about and come up with a compelling idea for people there. But yeah, no bad ideas.
You know, something we don't get enough of, and I think you're very good at, is science coverage and you know, just talking about it.
Yeah, I would. You know, I should. I have talked to Kiki. Dr. Kiki's going to be on the last episode of Tech News Today on December 30th. She was good enough to be able to be on, so I can thank her for being there in the early days, if nothing else. But yeah, maybe there's, if nothing else, I'm going to try to guest on TWiZ more on This Week in Science.
Right.
But yeah, I would like to do more science stuff. Science stuff, too.
I think you and Andrew Main should do a science show specifically dedicated to SpaceX.
That would be fun. That would be really fun. That's a busy man right now.
That is a busy man.
And I can't trust him, obviously.
Nope, nobody can.
Because you can't trust Andrew Main. Mm-hmm. That's the name of the show, basically. Not really slamming. 3D printers, man. You're talking my language, Chris. I love me some 3D printers. Maybe a future trends show, although those never do well. They always sound fun, but they never do well.
And why don't they do well? I mean, what is the reason for... I mean, that sounds like it would be...
I don't know why. We did one at Tech TV that flopped. We did one at CNET that flopped. And every print version, I don't want to say print, but you know, text version of stories that I've ever did at either website, just like you put the word future, and frankly, forecast flopped. It rose, and then it peaked, and then it declined.
What's flopping? When you say flop, I mean, those of us who podcast ourselves, your flops might be our dream position.
Yeah, no, when I'm talking about the TV and CNET stuff, like, I'm talking, like, hundreds, you know? Which, sure, for some podcasters, that would be success still.
Too, hundreds of people? Yeah, I hope you mean hundreds of thousands.
No, I'm talking, like, literally on the CNET one that I'm thinking of, it would get hundreds of downloads, or hundreds of streams per episode.
Okay.
Forecast did a little better than that. Towards the end, it was not, it was four figures. I don't even remember what it was. But yeah, no, it was bad. And again, like you said, you're right. You know, it depends on where you are. Some people would consider that a success. I'd consider that a success if East meets West got consistently, you know, in the thousands. I think it still kind of does, although because we stopped doing it regularly, it's declined. But I don't care about that. That's just recreational podcast. But yeah, those I don't know what... Anyway, back to the point. Future trend stuff just always sounds interesting, and then when you do it, everyone says it sounds interesting, and no one actually...
You shouldn't call it future trends or anything like that. It should be lasers, robots, and 3D printers. There you go.
The funny thing is, if you look at Fast Company, one of their, you know, longest running sections in the magazine is called "What's Next." And, you know, it's been around since, the, I think, the beginning of the magazine, and it's only increased. Or maybe that's Wired magazine. But either way, that's all about, well, trends.
Yeah, I know. That's a tough nut to crack. Like, how to actually make that work the right way. I'm going to take a couple more questions from the Hangout here. I think Derek Chen, are you in the chat? Because it's t2t2.eu, join t2t2. Most clients will just take you right there. Claudia, what about a show about current tech topics but in a crossfire kind of format where Tom takes one position, Brian argues another position, like a more debating-focused show? Do you guys like that when it's... when it's set up that way, or
Journey,
like, you know,
Journey
they're going to be on opposite
idea.
Sides and they're faking it. Like, maybe, you know, like, oh, well, he's just taking that position. Is that?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to talk over you.
Go ahead.
At all. But yeah, Jury mentioned that on Jury Talks this week, this weekend, that he wanted to do a debating show where people take the other side and have to argue it. So you should get Jury in here. Where the hell is he anyways?
Well, I mean, if it's a format that didn't work, we never would have had Roger Ebert and Siskel and Ebert. It's obviously a format that works.
Mm-hmm. That's fair. That's a good point. Although they sometimes agreed. I never got the sense that they were just taking opposite sides for the sake of it, though. Maybe they were just good at it, which they were. I hesitate to ever just take the opposite side just to take the opposite side, you know? Like, that seems fake.
But there might be some authentic, like, very geeky points that might be interesting, you know, like cloning or stuff like that. And people might have genuine contrasting opinions, and that might be interesting on...
No, and that would also be good for entertainment, you know, if you're going to argue.
Oh, for sure. Yeah.
So on that level, yeah.
Conflict is always sells.
Yeah.
Just ask CNN.
Yeah.
Have you ever thought of doing maybe a satirical show, like basically a daily show, but for tech?
It was called Tech News Today. That none of that was serious.
Oh. Yeah. Hold on.
Those are all lies. Every last show. Padre SJ in the chat room says, I've been thinking about a show like that, but the trick is that you can switch sides at any given time. It takes away the faking it factor and makes it more about the fact that all issues have multiple sides. That's cool. That's a cool idea.
Yeah, I like that idea.
It's like you go in it with the premise that this isn't like us pretending to be on the sides, but you're like, okay, now switch sides and argue the other side. Like it's a rhetoric exercise.
Well, that's like debate club.
Yeah.
That's the way debate clubs and in high schools and colleges work, is that, you know, you basically study one topic for the entire year, at least this is the way it used to be, and then, you know, you show up to the debate and you could be either side, pro or con. And you had to actually argue as if you really care, pro or con.
Yeah, and it keeps the fake part out of it, because it actually, you're not faking, you're testing your skills. One of the things that changed my mind about capital punishment was when I had to debate the opposite side in college, and you actually start to look into the stats and the actual facts and stuff. It's a great way to avoid this idea that, like, you're either right or you're wrong, you know? That's interesting. Good stuff.
Chimera would like to say that he'd like that show to be called Tom Flicked.
Tom Flicked.
Tom Flicked?
I like what Strength said, Devil's Tech Advocate.
Ooh, that's a great one.
Yeah. You know, I don't want to steal this idea, though, Padre. You should totally do that.
Oh, wow.
I'll be on that show. I'll guest or whatever.
Mass debating.
Because it's Padre. Nice.
Yeah.
Mass effect. Andy Beach says, spoilers on the show. I would absolutely watch that. Talk about the current favorite shows, but also have a book club series. You could actually fold a lot of those ideas into a spoiler zone series, where you have the book club for television shows, plus the sort of like what we're watching going into that. Yeah, maybe. That's Eduardo actually keeps putting drunk tech history as a question. That's not a question. I think it's a self-description.
The one earlier just said no. So, you know.
Yeah, I saw that one too. I like this. Ryan Fairchild says, I'd like to see a tech news show about everyday tech upgrades, things in tech that we may not know about that can improve our daily lives, be it personal or work. That's good. That's interesting feedback. You know, and that's something we always struggle with, which is how much of the news should be practical and how much of the news should be, like, what companies are up to. And it's always a balance because you're trying to figure out, well, what is the audience going to feel like they should have heard when they hear about it later, you know? Because that's the proposition of a digest show like ours, is I'm giving you a briefing so that you should be able to go out into a tech world and be reasonably up to date on what's happening. Possibly, if we're doing our job right, you know a little bit more than everybody else in the room. Thanks, Ryan. And then Brian says, Tom.
I'm assuming you've already answered whether you would do a daily tech show again.
Yes. Of some sort. Of some type, yes.
So the answer is yes, you would. Would you do it on your own, or would that require... I would imagine that would require...
Yeah, you weren't here earlier, and the answer was yes.
Ah.
I would do it on my own, or with someone else, or for a network. I'm still in the middle of figuring all that stuff out, so I got to just look at all the options. I don't even know what all the options are yet. First Tech, Brandon Foster says, a debate show. I like that. It's a good name. I can't imagine somebody hasn't taken that. Oh, thank you, Perface, for radio.
On the
weekly
other
tech
hand,
podcast called Liquid Fridays. I don't think anyone needs to do that.
On the other hand, also, you could go, like, totally impractical. You could find, like, the tech that didn't make it, and that was, you know, ridiculously impractical at the time it was built, and how and why it didn't work.
Like Spruce Goose, but...
Yes.
But obviously, like, that's the iconic version.
Right, like the Newton and all kinds of different stuff, and that'd be interesting.
I guess a podcast on podcasting would be too meta.
Yeah, I've thought about that, though. Like, interview podcasters about podcasting.
A few folks do that already.
Yeah. Interview podcasters about podcasting on community access television.
That really would be meta. And retro at the same time. You'd be a hipster. Instant hipster.
That's right. I could wear more flannel.
Yep.
Ivan says, do you have any restrictions on working with anyone from the TWiT network? I love the chemistry between you and other previous hosts. No, of course not. I'm not going to take anyone from there. But no. I mean, I think that's all fine. That's all good.
I like Tom, this idea. Tom reads the tech news to Django.
Go ahead, Sperling.
I was going to say, I like this idea that Spring Rubber had. Tom reads the tech news to Django and Sawyer.
All right, I shut them out because they were barking all the time earlier.
Somebody had earlier suggested a pet tech show anyway, while the barking was happening.
Petopia.
And I want to add in there that I don't think that, like, hearing Sawyer or Django bark was anything more than just enjoyable to the audience. Maybe that's just me, my opinion, but I think I loved the fact that there is such a human element to TWiT and the way things have been running, that we all have like an interactive part to the show. And so I just feel like all of that is just so, like, you know, heartwarming and great to watch. Anyways, that's my point.
Well, thanks. I don't really mind it all that much when Sawyer just goes up, barks a few times, and you're like, oh, stop that, Sawyer, and we're done. earlier, it got to be too much. I couldn't hear what you guys were saying over the barking, so I kind of had to give him the boot, unfortunately. But yeah, I agree. I like that kind of flavor as well, for sure. Paxton says, love your book about tech history. That was fun to read. Been following you for a long time. Oh, well, that's just a nice thing to say. Thank you, Paxton.
Slim Billy has a good name, Tomcast. I'm sure somebody said that already, but Slim Billy just mentioned it.
Right, or Tom News Today. Yeah, those are, I don't know. Those are all sound good until I actually go to pick a name, and then I'm like, I don't want to put my name, my old name in there. I don't know why.
Tom, who dat in chat says, does anyone have any analytics or which shows ideas can make enough money to be a career choice? Well, I mean, I think you've already picked your career choice here, have you thought about that? You know, where you could generate money and how would that work and how can we help you with that?
I'm not too concerned with it as far as topics go. To me, the way that I approach things, and not everybody agrees with this, is to do the things that I'm most passionate about and feel like I can actually contribute something positive. And then take that and figure out, okay, and then how do we make that into a going concern? And proportion the things in my life around which of those are most successful at being a going concern, which is why Tech News Today is the bulk, right? That is the most successful thing that I have ever done.
More successful than Buzz Out Loud?
Yeah. Yeah, it has been. And probably just because, those were parallel trajectories for a while. If I had stayed at CNET and they had wanted to keep Buzz Out Loud going, it might have been just as successful as TNT, maybe. I don't know. It's, those are all what ifs.
But for you, it's not so much about what's going to make the money. I think that my understanding, because as knowing you as a very creative kind of person, is that you want to do the thing that you love to do, and it that doesn't really matter. Because if you do what you love to do successfully, then, is that where you're coming from?
Or? Yeah, as far as topics, like, should I do a show about this or a show about this? And so I want ideas like that to be like, which ones sound like good ideas, like fun ideas? And then there's the selection of, like, that sounds like a fun idea, but I'm the only person who would ever listen to it because no one else wants a podcast about how mercantilism is related to digital rights management. I am the only person who would want that podcast. But there are plenty of ideas where you get that cross-section, right? And you go, okay, good topic, got a fair chance of success. That's when I think you start looking like, and that's what I'm doing today, is like, okay, what things do you like? There's a qualitative aspect of it where you, and all of us who have done this for a while have that sense of like being able to tell the temperature from the hardcore people and the general people. And then that's analytics is where you find out like, okay, is it getting numbers? Are there other things that are successful like that? What are the things that actually resonate with the audience within that show topic? How do you best do that show? And that's why TNT changed over the years, right? It was because we realized, well, wait a minute. One way... We like doing news views and doing headline versions of stuff, and we like doing the discussion, but we're getting a consistent slice of people saying, I wish you'd put the headlines at the front because I don't always have time to listen through the whole show. So eventually we did that, and we looked, and we got almost zero. We always get a complaint about something. We got almost zero complaints about the switch, and we're like, boom, now we know. That's the right way. And so... I've taken this model from Buzz Out Loud, which is like, just do the show you want to do and then watch and look for the reactions to it. And then don't let the audience dictate it, but you react and say, like, you know what? I've been thinking along those same lines. I've been wondering if that was a better idea or not, and the audience seems to want that, so let's switch it. You have to be a little open-minded. I mean, some people are just like, no, I'm the visionary, and this is how I'm going to do it, and that's it. And that works sometimes, too, for sure, because if you're passionate enough, that's fine. I totally went off philosophizing there, sorry.
No, I think that was great. Also, there was another one, and I'm sorry, I'm sure other people have things to jump in, but someone said, I'm not familiar with the area, but is there a way that you could do a podcast where you check out nerd/geek/tech innovators in places in the LA area?
Yeah.
And that way you get out of the studio and set and visit them, and,
yeah,
and it would be fresh every week. Which, yeah, you can get out of your place and go somewhere, but it's going to take you 5 hours to get down the 134 or the 101.
Yeah, there's that, for sure. The 405.
The 405. Don't even go there.
That's right there. Yeah.
Oh, man. Okay, yeah. I get it.
But even beyond that, field production is always more difficult, usually more expensive. And that's no reason not to do it. But it's a different proposition to take cameras out into the field, set up lights, mic people properly, avoid the wind, get good content, and then bring it back and edit it. Honestly, I'll tell you what the most attractive option is. And I'm not saying this is the best option, but the most attractive option is I do all the things that I normally do for research. I sit down, I turn on a Google Hangout, I run Audio Hijack, I do a show, maybe I've got guests like you guys, you know, on a Hangout, I finish the show, Google Hangout encodes the video, post it to YouTube, I download it, post it to a podcast, take the audio, post it to a podcast, done. Well, anybody can do that.
That doesn't sound like a lot of work at all. Although I guess technically Google Hangout and YouTube are doing most of the work there.
Yeah, they're picking up the work is all the content, and that's the ideal, right? That's what Hunter S. Thompson wanted. He didn't even want to write things. He just wanted to think and speak and have it immediately turned into articles. And that's the ideal that we're actually getting close to being able to do with the internet, is you can just focus on making the content and not worry about the trappings of it, unless that's the content. Right? I'm not saying that good filmmakers with amazing lighting skills are worthless. I'm just saying they're not essential to every type of medium. And so if somebody wants to make a beautiful film, that's an artwork on its own. But if somebody's just like, I just need it to be good enough so that you're not distracted from the message or from the thing I'm trying to talk about.
Well, then do you need, you mentioned Audio Hijack and a couple of other technical pieces of software. Do you actually need that? Would you want to be working with a TriCaster and a mixer and three different desktop computers to bring in all of these Skype feeds, or is Google Hangout really, I don't want to say good enough, but is that the direction you're headed?
I don't know. That's the easiest direction, right? It doesn't look as good yet, anyway. Yeah. They keep improving it, but yeah, if you want the highest quality video, then you probably should do a TriCaster and pray that someone invents something better than Skype, and there's other directions to go in, but Hangout is good enough. I know you didn't want to say it, but it's kind of true, and it's not a bad option. I don't know. That's actually a good thing. I'm curious because some people I've talked to have said, no. Whatever you launch next, it's got to look great. It's got to be top quality video. And I've talked to other people that I respect just as much who are like, audio is where it's at. Your video is just spy cam. That's just that's all you need it for, is just to give people a look into what you're doing. And Hangout is more than good enough for that. I'm curious what you guys think.
You know, I spoke to the CEO of Blueberry recently, and
Blueberry,
the PowerPress, the WordPress.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I just want to make sure people didn't think you were accidentally meaning BlackBerry.
No.
He's talking about Blueberry. It's a real thing.
Yeah, and BlackBerry, does that exist? Well, I guess it does exist.
No, it's RIM. BlackBerry.
Right. Yeah. And he said, look, you know, you really need to do video. And I said, well, why would I need to do video? All we do is talk about, entertainment news and interview entertainment journalists or industry people. And he said, you know what? People will turn it on, put it on in the background on Roku or Apple TV, and, you know, it's just another way, and it's for him and for what his metrics are showing, not only for his own shows, but also for the shows that he's hosting, which are a good percentage of the podcasts out there, that more people are watching the video streams, even though they may only be listening to them.
That's how I ingest my podcasts. Is I usually turn on the video stream and watch it in the back, or have it running in the background while I'm listening. Because then I have the option to listen to it only, or, you know, get a view into what you're doing, and it's best of both worlds.
It's interesting. I'm watching the chat room responses to this, and it's 50-50-ish. You know, some people saying, no, the video's fine. Google Hangout's good enough. I don't even care about the video. There's other people saying the video is essential. The video is why I consume it. You know, that you must have good video.
If we're talking, I mean, the reason I even started watching TWiT to begin with was because of the video, to be honest.
Because of the quality of the video or because they
had
video?
No, just because they have video. Yeah. Most of the time, I watch it on, what is it, the bitstream, the 400 kilobyte bitstream, I think it is. I watch it on a low bandwidth. You know, I don't have a great connection at work, and that's usually where I'm at when I'm watching it. And so just having the video is important to me. It doesn't have to be high quality video.
Well, and there's a difference between the high quality stream and the high quality look, right? I mean, this is a high quality look. The TWiT folks paid for the lights, and Leo got Brent Bai to come over, and they paid him to hang the lights, and that's why this looks as good as it does. You know, I bought the equipment, I set up everything else, I ran the cables and all, I did all the rest of this myself. But that was the one thing I could not replicate, and it makes all the difference. So there's that side of it, which I feel like, okay, well, I'm sure I can find lighting people to help me out if I need to set up a second camera or things like that. And Brent probably would help me out. But what about the streaming quality, right? And that's where Google Hangout is, like I said, it's getting better.
Yeah.
And right now it looks pretty good, I think. And it has to do with bandwidth, et cetera.
Well, yeah, Google Hangout, they throttle their stream according to what you have, obviously.
Yeah. And that's one of the annoying things is when you switch back and forth.
Yes.
On some, like yours is pixelated for like just the briefest of seconds when you come back on screen, and then it looks great, but there's just that like that tiny flash that some people won't even notice, but other people will just be like, oh man, this is a video artifact, so annoying, I can't watch this.
Well, what kind of bandwidth do you have coming into your studio now? Because
300 megabits per second.
And how in the world did you get that?
FiOS.
FiOS. Okay, so something that nobody—well, at least a lot of people in LA, where you are, you can get it. But
yeah, it's all over the West Side, and I luckily my wife got a job on the West Side, so we were able to get that. Otherwise, I would have been screwed a long time ago.
And what is it up? It's 300 awesome. Down, but up is.
Oh, up is 65. So it's it's ridiculous. I'm like, come on, just give me all of it. What's wrong with you people? and they have 500 available apparently, but the last time I checked, they didn't offer it here because I was willing to fork out for it, man. I was like, I don't care.
Tom, I put out a straw poll to ask people if video is a must for a podcast.
Ooh, good idea. Thanks, Jackie.
Yeah, no problem. And it looks like it's overwhelming, or 64% so far, but we don't have a lot of responders yet that are saying that video is necessary.
So necessary.
I know I like to watch TNT. I listen to it all the time, but I like to watch it because I like to see the reactions. Back and forth.
A little, that makes sense. Tensor, I guess. Especially for this audience, right? Go ahead.
Sorry. Perface for Radio says, video is good. Eye contact, even virtual eye contact, helps personalize some types of content. also has the ability, as just mentioned, of using the video devices to listen to the audio.
Yeah, one thing we've all at the cottage and at the studio have gotten good at is pretending that that Canon HD camera that I'm looking at right now is you. I don't, and I'm talking to you guys in the Hangout. Your faces are down there, and I'm like, down there. Yeah, tensor guy. I mean, you're right.
Yeah, that does take some getting used to. It is.
Yeah.
I'm not good at it, but I've noticed you're quite good at it.
There's a little of a selection bias in this video question, obviously, because these are people who are streaming video and willing to be in the chat room. Because the numbers are the opposite. The numbers are like two-thirds audio for TNT.
Well, that's because some of us just can't catch it, right? So we still listen to it.
So you watch the streaming, but you download the audio. And,
yeah.
Okay.
They're downloading it to the phones, you know, like if you're listening to it on your phone, you're listening to it in your car, you know, I do that when I'm traveling.
Yeah, that's how it is for me. Go ahead, JC.
Yeah, because that's how it is for me. Like, I'll walk out of work and just hit my podcast app, and that tiny vial is already there, TNT, and it's just ready to go for my drive.
Yeah, I do the same thing.
And I think that has a lot to do with data plans. You know, with cell phone networks that you have a cap, so you don't want to download the video onto your phone. Like you're absolutely going to listen to the audio first.
A couple other questions I want to get to here, and I'm sorry, Jackie. Yes.
No, go ahead.
That's a good statement.
And I just want to say I have to go, unfortunately.
Oh, sorry, Sperling, but thanks for jumping in, man. I appreciate it. I'm glad I noticed you. In there. I didn't want to go without meeting you. We'll talk soon.
Yes, indeed. Look forward to it.
All right, man.
Bye.
Graham wants to know, are you going to do a Reddit for the show? I guess the Reddit for Tech News Today happened without me. It was just people who wanted to do it, so hopefully people will want to do that again. I guess if they don't, I'll go in and make sure it happens, because I think that's indispensable to have that voice. It's not the determination. I think a lot of people, when we first launched it, thought we were going to do the show based on the Reddit. Like, whatever got the most votes, that's what we'll talk about. I think that's a bad idea, because it's never all your audience. But it's a section of your audience that you have to pay attention to. So, yes, I would like to do that. Could yourself, Mollywood Veronica, do an MGM-style podcasting house? You know, Sony Studios are the old MGM studios. Maybe we could just buy that. It's not that far away. Here, I'm actually really, really glad that Gordon asked this one. Does it bother you that a certain segment of your fan base is raising pitchforks against your former employer? Do you have a message for that group? Yes, it bothers me. Stop it. There is no reason to raise pitchforks against Leo or anyone else at TWiT. Just cut it out. Let's stay positive. Let's look forward. Leave it alone, please. Jonathan R., just to cheer things up after that, says, maybe a weekly show on technology on a tight budget, like good alternatives to pricey popular tech, hacks to achieve high-quality tech at minimal cost.
Oh, cool.
I think that's a great idea.
I like that.
Because that also doesn't cost a lot, because you have to do safe.
Yeah, your budget doesn't have to be as big.
You know, and you could do like those fashion things where this is the outfit on Vogue, whatever, and you could do it for $10 by doing this.
That's a very Iazzy show, though, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
I like that.
You know, that's actually a really good one, though, because I look at Brian Brushwood's studio, and that must have cost him thousands and thousands of dollars to put together. You know, but going back into what we just talked about, there are other people who want to start podcasts, who want to start video podcasts, or, you know, things like that, that still want it to look nice, but don't have the budget to spend on, I don't know the kind of cameras Brian has, but, you know, even the Skype machine that he's using, we don't have the budget to spend on that kind of stuff. Sure. Showing them how to do that for cheaper would be fantastic.
That would actually be a great thing. I think that there are a lot of people that watch a lot of TWiT that are, you know, I mean, I do some silly things on the internet as well, and, you know, just to kind of play around. But yeah, no, I mean, it would be great to get some insight on how to do your own show, other than buying a C920.
Yeah, Ed points out in the chat room, he's like, that's a lot of prep for that type of show, and he's right. But you can do it as a limited series. You don't have to do it as an ongoing, like, oh, we're going to come up with a new way to do this every week, right? You can just do it as a 12-parter or something. This is the camera that, one of the cameras that Brian has, by the way.
Yeah.
This Panasonic. It doesn't work, it doesn't play very nicely with my Blackmagic, which is why I haven't been using it. But I will definitely, if I need a second camera, which I probably will, I will be using that. You can find it used for around $600 right now. Not cheap, I know. But as far as the quality goes, that's one of the most affordable ones. If you just want cheap and good, Logitech C910 is
amazing. Yeah, I have one of those.
Patrick's here.
Yay, you finally made it in, Patrick. Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, and we were so distracted earlier. I just want to say thanks to Chad. For showing up. I barely got to say two words to him, and then he was gone before I even noticed. But good to see you too, man. I was trying to invite you.
Yeah, they were going to my phone.
Oh.
So, I'm on my phone.
Oh, well, that's weird. I wonder why that is.
Just to wrap up that idea, I think how you guys do... Shoot, I just forgot the name of it. The autopilot. How you do that show where you have a certain set amount of episodes that you're doing would be a great way to do tech on a budget.
Yeah.
You don't have to do a weekly show. I mean, most TV episodes that we consume are a certain amount of shows before it's over for the season.
Do you know... We do that with It's a Thing, too, right? We record them in, like, and we do this with autopilot, three bunches, usually, of four episodes apiece. Mm-hmm. And we started to get people complaining that we weren't just releasing them all the day we recorded them, which would be a lot more editing, but it's possible. I'm curious if people actually want, like, that kind of bulk release schedule, like Netflix is doing.
I was going to say that.
You know, or if they prefer, because it's a podcast, that they, you know, they want it doled out in pieces, in a regular format, so they have time to digest it and think about it and then come back for the next one.
I think the people who complain about that are the ones who are used to digesting all of the content at one time on Netflix and just having all of that available to them. Personally... And this is, chat room, I don't want you guys to get too mad at me. This is just me. I prefer to have it weekly. I have so much other stuff to keep up on anyway that having a weekly show would be fine.
I enjoy getting like a little present in my podcatcher.
Yeah.
It's weird, but there's something nice about that.
I think you can do both. There's no reason you can't just make, like, all four available for download directly and then say, oh, for those who prefer to have them spaced out, here they are. But would that make you feel weird if you're getting the podcast and you know they're all out there already?
Well, maybe if it's, like, your recommended sequence or whatever, you know, maybe if they're not in order usually. But, oh, this is the order I would listen to.
Mm-hmm. You mean doing something like the Totally Rad Show did, where they broke it up eventually, because they had like a once a week, and then they broke it up, but they recorded it all at the same time and just changed shirts.
Yeah,
that kind of thing, or
yeah, and just releasing as you get them done.
Right.
Because that's what we did with Sword and Laser too. We recorded four episodes at a shot, and changed our outfit between two of them. Snowshoe says if there was a daily show, it would need to be short. Seems like more people want long in this audience. Not sure if that's true overall.
Never mind. What I was going to say has no real benefit. Never mind.
Well, what I would say, like, say is
pudding
that
is tasty or something. Or?
Well, no, I was gonna say.
Go.
tech shows in particular seem to lack beginning to end. You know, they show you a little bit, and then they tell you, or they show you the finished product. They don't ever really give you a full how-to. But I don't really know that that's necessary. I mean, if you have detailed show notes or whatever, then that's fine. A la know-how, you know, IaaS does a very good job of having detailed show notes to where he doesn't need to show the entire start to finish.
Mm-hmm.
So my point is moot.
Hmm. No, it's a fair point though. Even if it's mute.
What I would like to say is I absolutely love that Tech News Today is on every day of the week of the work yes. week. And it helps me get through the work week because okay. I know that I can just turn into it and listen to it while I'm working or doing something else, and it really gets me through a lot. And I have a feeling that a lot of other people would feel exactly the same way. If you could do something that is daily, you know, I think that would be amazing. But, you know, we'll see where you're going from here. But you know who to call on for help.
I will. You'll not be able to stop me, Jackie. I will do a daily show of some sort. Whether it's just me in my T-shirt standing out in front of my house, it'll be a daily show. I have a T-shirt. I really do. I used to wear it.
I believe it.
Should we have a wiki? Because I'm starting to realize, like, we've got questions, which I'm never going to get to all these questions in this spreadsheet in one hangout. We're going to have to wrap it up soon. We've been going for a couple hours.
Okay.
But
we'll do that.
I wouldn't mind answering questions kind of on the fly somehow, or maybe finding common ones and posting them up. And then there's the various chat rooms and databases and all of these things going on. Is that the best way, though? I'm just wondering how we should aggregate it all.
Well, we're looking for you for guidance on that. Like, we can talk off of this session here about how we're going to combine it all. And I think that having to go through TomMerritt.com is the perfect place. But, you know, if we can get these things together to you so you can post them on your website where people can go here to link yeah. to, you know, list their skills, you know, all that stuff.
Patrick has some experience with the, you know, aggregating stuff, like the BBpedia and stuff. I'd love to hear his insight.
Well, the wiki works great as long as people keep it up to date. If there's only one or two people contributing, then it just languishes and dies.
Yeah. That's always the way with the wiki. And I would kind of like that stuff to be self-organized, for you guys to be the owners of it, rather than me sort of dictating, if you know what I mean.
Absolutely, I agree.
I'm going to lightning round through these questions that are in the actual Google Hangout. Will Tom finally dance on the new show? You'll just have to tune in and find out. All options are on the table. Ian, Jackie is right. Every day for TNT absolutely works, but it does depend on the format of the show. Yes, thank you. I will make sure not to do a crappy format of the show. I'll try it. You always gave us fans... Oh, I think I already read this one. Oh, this is Bob asking about the Kickstarter. I must have just forgot to check it off. But yes, Kickstarters, possibly, or Indiegogos or something, or Patreon, or PayPal donation, or sponsors, or all of that. How about a monthly episode on tech for people with disabilities, Tom asks. I do love doing accessibility stories, and I think they're really important. So I definitely am going to keep that in mind. Thank you, Tom. Post replies on G+. I love the short videos you made that just answered questions. Ivan says, "Yeah, I can do more of those. Those are fun to do, and maybe I can do them as a hangout or something." Rooster Teeth uses the link dump to show images and links during an audio podcast. While I might not click the link, I often look at the images to feel more connected to the story during my commute. I've been hoping TNT would do this. Could you consider? I have always resisted that stuff, even on Buzz Out Loud, because it's so much extra work for so much little return. There's not enough people, I think, that usually want that, at least that I hear use it. So I always thought, well, I could spend that time making the show better in other ways. Tom danced last week, says Jonathan Stein. Did I? I guess I sort of did. Tom, have you and Schwood talked about using his equipment for the production side of things since he has multiple Skype capabilities? We've talked about all kinds of things, including that. A show focusing on how cutting-edge tech, quantum computing, carbon nanotubes are being developed named Tech News Tomorrow. I like the idea. It's a cheeky, funny name. Video is relevant, but not to the point of counting someone's eyelashes. I love Tom's facial expressions and body language. You can't replicate it, but you don't need high-quality video. Boris has one question. Oi? Yeah, thank you for your insight. That's very helpful. Perhaps if it is stupid and it works, it is not stupid. Unlikely applications of technology show. Awesome idea, Todd. Alpha Geek with a good idea. That's good. I'm going to try to remember that one. Would you want to do shows over Google Hangouts where you have some level of interaction over things like Skype? We had kind of addressed that already, Eduardo, but definitely something to consider. Have a section called Grace Hopper. Yes, Dan. Happy birthday, Grace Hopper. Wow, there's more in here than I expected. How about a show for fitness and health technology? I think that's a segment. I mean, I think somebody could do a full show. I don't think that's a full show for me, but it's definitely a segment type thing. Are you getting paid for whatever this new thing is? You do need to stay alive to make podcasts. Yes, Daryl. That is one consideration, is how do I actually stay alive while I do all of this, and how do I get paid? How about monthly eps with international guests because they bring fresh perspectives? That sort of happens anyway, but yeah, I'm not against that. What's your new job title and gadget? I wish. Mark says, are you wanting to create a new frame rate style show or a new show, or what type of show are you looking to do? Yes and yes. Will the frog pants stuff have a video component? Yeah. Yeah, Scott. Don't waste all your questions now, Scott. I promised Scott Ryan Hart of 20 Questions that I would do a 20 Questions with him after the first of the year as my first official post interview. So there's a freebie for you. Todd says, perhaps do it in reverse. Profile something each episode that seemed like a non-starter but then became vital tech. Interesting. When will you do the film sack about 2012? Yeah, I never. When the world ends. No, I don't know. Someday. We'll figure it out. There are many of us who listen while driving and stop listening to shows that become too video-focused, where listening becomes hard to do without visual. Yeah, I'm Joel, I am committed to anything I do with video should still work in audio. It shouldn't. There may be sections where you have to say, if you can look at it later or get the link or something like that, because it really is a good illustration, but I try never to just plow through and leave people out. Retro tech, the trailing edge, roundtable discussion is an awesome format, I agree. Will you be the next blogger turned tech evangelist? I don't even know what tech evangelists are. I hear that all the time. Spoiler zone is my favorite part of frame rate. Thank you. Will we be seeing, hearing more of East Meets West? We don't know. We never know. Week by week. We just don't know. I think y'all should do a show where you just talk about what you're drinking. You could call it rum and lager. Veronica needs to guest. That sounds dangerous. I don't know if I want to commit to that. What's crucial, which is consistent through all the shows you have done, is digesting and breaking down the information, whether it is geek culture, tech, or books. Good to know. Thanks, CJ. That's helpful. Tom, the most important question, how much wood would a woodchuck check? Google it, all right? Greg, TVZ gone. I think the talk and deeper introspection is the best part. It's a reason that I love Andy Anako on TWiT, 5x5, and writing. He takes his time to really consider the topics. I agree. I love that about Andy as well. How about a show on conventions? That means you have to go to conventions, which is...
That's my show. I already do that.
Yeah, that's right. What am I talking about? We got Patrick Delahanty right there. He does that.
I thought he meant on conventions, like, ways of doing things.
Oh, like a conventional method?
Yes.
The conventional method show?
Yes.
Most people tie their shoes with loops.
Yes.
All right.
18 conventions for lacing your shoes.
Curtis B says, how about a show where one revisits the effects of a news tech story, say, a year later to see if it lived up to the expectations and what changed? Maybe, although, Curtis B, that's a great idea in theory. I feel like just from the predictions results shows we've done over the year, it doesn't actually end up being that one-to-one. Like, it's kind of hard to track those actual results. Graham says breaking news type specials. Maybe. Probably not priority, but maybe. Do you think it would be worth it to do a show specifically on Bitcoin? I don't know. What do you guys think? Bitcoin? I mean, it's trendy right now. That seems like a financial show in the end. It's a bit of a crypto show, too, I guess.
I really enjoyed the time you were with Insecurity Now with, what's his
Steve Gibson.
Yes, Steve Gibson.
Yeah.
That whole discussion on Squirrel and stuff, that was very interesting.
Yeah, I agree. I love doing those shows with Steve, so... Who knows? Maybe I'll convince him to let me do some Security Nows or something. Or maybe Steve and I can do like a limited series. Like something that doesn't compete with Security Now, but
right.
More Tom, coverage of
Tom, yes. did you see Padre SJ's suggestion about the final episode of TNT? Where you wake up in a hospital.
For your last episode of TNT, can we show you waking up in a hospital bed with a doctor explaining the last 5 years of all the dream and you were in a coma from a tragic Wii accident? Or if you don't like that coma idea, can you really grow out your beard, shed your coat or flannel jacket, and announce at the end of TNT that you're going off into the wild to become a lumberjack? I seriously have suggested to Mike Elgin that I regenerate into him at the end.
Oh my God.
I thought that was the secret. I was hoping for that. I heard about that and I was hoping you would do that.
He didn't really directly respond to that part of the it was a sort of a hey, congratulations, man. I think you're great and I think you're gonna do a great job. By the way, I don't know if you're a Doctor Who fan, but bloody billy, here's my crazy idea. So I don't know. That would be my favorite. More coverage of politics. Yeah, you like that. that's trouble. And that's what East Meets West is for me to get in trouble safely. Need to do a live chat show from time to time. You know, actually, Ed, this is really fun. I'm sorry, it was a little bit tough off the beginning because, honestly, I was really nervous. And the dog started barking like crazy and everything. But, yeah, I think, by the way, huge thanks to Brian Brushwood for being my flying cover for me at the beginning of the show. I think we could do something like this more often. I like it. We're starting to plow back into stuff from earlier, like video needs to be good. Will you keep the movie draft in your new cord cutting show? We'll definitely keep the movie draft one way or another. Brian and Justin will. That's not going anywhere. Podcast for growing beards. That might be a very slow podcast.
Tom, here's one from Dark Demon. He says, I feel like Tom works best when he's either being the authoritative settle down children show like TNT, a debate show like Framerate, or a I'm going to derail this show like when in NSFW. So Tom, which is your favorite kind to do?
Well, that's why I get to do, I like doing different ones. That's actually one of the reasons that I love doing an NSFW show, is because for once I don't have to be the guy that keeps it moving along. That's such a relief. You don't even know. Yeah, it's fun to be the troublemaker sometimes. So yeah, I like all of them. Would you consider going towards a more creative angle? I think I know what Jason means. Something like an online series of some sort. He's talking, he means dramatic, or I think somebody else asked earlier about scripted or something. I don't know. Somebody asked me actually recently because I got a gig doing interviews for a movie launch. It was fun, but it was weird. And the person's like, "Are you an actor too?" And I'm like, "Nope." And she looked shocked, like, "Really?" I'm like, "Yeah, no, don't want to do that." I mean, yeah, I would do it for fun, for goofiness, but. I don't know about that. And so doing some kind of creative series. I would never say never. It could be fun. That's not really what I do, though. Just admit it. You want to move to Canada. We have much imported bourbon and great rye. We just pay a lot of tax on it. Anthony Marco, there tomorrow. Oh, not actually there tomorrow. But he makes a compelling case. Oh, you know what? Catherine French asks, maybe add a gaming or what are we playing segment into one of the shows that we're kicking around. What do you guys think of an esports segment in a daily tech news show? Or maybe it's a weekly segment in a daily tech news show, but something that's brings in the esports element, say, hey, these are the major tournaments going on, these are the people leading. Oh. Is that too far afield, like the StarCraft and the Hearthstone and the League of Legends, all that stuff? Or would that be... Yeah?
Yeah, I think it would be interesting. I mean, they have a huge following. For example, StarCraft is just ridiculous. It's like watching, you know, pro football and stuff. So yeah, I think there's space for that. At least my
opinion. Just worry that, and I'm thinking something short, obviously, but I just worry that it's too different, and that the people who like the policy and the earnings report stories and the trends and the buzz go, I don't really know anything about esports. The way it would work is if the people who don't necessarily know anything about esports start to feel like the sports report in the news, like they're there for the politics, but they're like, oh, it's interesting that the Cardinals won or whatever. Maybe they start to feel like, oh, I've heard of those teams now, you know?
Yeah.
Tom, I would absolutely agree. As somebody who absolutely doesn't know anything about sports, you can name a team, and I don't know if it's football or baseball or anything. I'm in that kind of realm, but... You know, the part that I would pick up or follow is how is it impacting, you know, what's trending over the internet or you know, or how sales are done or how things grow. But yeah, I absolutely don't follow sports in any way, shape, or form. But that would be it. That would be where I would come from. So if you could bring that element into it, where it's focused more on, you know, how's technology being used to broadcast this, you know, X, Y, Z or whatever. I don't even know because I don't know enough about sports.
No, I think Tom meant esports, like professional video games and stuff like that.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm talking about like the Korean StarCraft teams and the League of Legends.
That's how little I know what the hell you're talking about.
Yeah, and that's why it may not be right, because it may be too underground now.
Well,
I don't know. Some people, it's mixed in the chat room too.
You know, I'm actually interested in that.
Right.
Mainly because I don't know about it. I'd like to learn about it, but the people who I've seen that comment, or I guess commentate, are, I don't know, it's just hard to listen.
Inside. They're ridiculously inside, and it would be very interesting to have like a little bit of an outside perspective, like okay, this is what's going on in general. And I think I've just been introduced to StarCraft, for example, and it's huge, and... LOL as well and stuff like that. I think you would have a built-in audience, or a lot of people who are into it would be happy to have that sort of stuff being taken seriously outside of their niche area.
And Curtis B makes a good point. I mean, kind of like the spoiler zone on Framerate. You just throw it on at the end.
Yeah.
You know, it's a few minutes long or whatever, and people who don't want to watch it don't have to watch it.
I've got a few ideas of who might want to do something like that, but it would have to be somebody else. I mean, I'm not the guy to do it. I would need somebody. I would almost think about it like they record it and send it to me, and then I roll it in.
Yeah, like the frame show. Rate, like the frame rate, the movie draft minute.
Yeah, right, exactly. On NSFW show, the way they roll that in. So it'd have to be something like that, and somebody who actually really knows that stuff and knows like these are the important tournaments, these are the important teams, these are the important events. And what gave me the idea is I was watching that esports channel that just launched, and their Sports Center like tab was just fascinating because I was like, I don't know who any of these people are, but it's like watching SportsCenter and their teams and some of, you know, and their standings and all that stuff. Paul, you're nodding your head over here too.
Yeah. It's a really interesting avenue to go. It's a market that not many people have gone down.
Yeah.
That would be good. But the same time, the downside of that is that...
I don't know if I can hear you.
Not many people know
it. Yeah, because not many people know. Fordo... Longtime Buzztown resident, says, this is my first Google Hangout, loving this, though need my daily audio, not video tech podcast as a regular thing, and I'm a fan of your breaking down the daily news and collecting moolah from us. I have contributed to a startup podcast for a year. Okay, awesome. You're awesome. Thank you, Fordo.
By the way, the straw poll says as far as audio, video, it's video necessary, 40 votes, 68%. Audio is 32.
It's almost the opposite of the traffic side of that. That's interesting.
And then there was another one thrown up about weekly podcasts are all at one time, and weekly is blowing them away, 74%. 74% say weekly is their method of choice.
Yeah, I know. I do know that, and I'm probably going to do it daily anyway. just because I don't care. No, because there's a lot of competition for weekly type shows, right? Because that is the preferred way to do it. I prefer that as a consumer too, so I don't want to have too much of it. But I think to do the kind of show I'm talking about, it's defined as daily news, right? So maybe it just needs to be not even shorter, but more efficient. Like, I don't want to shortchange people. I don't know. There's a subreddit up now. Well, I don't know if it's a subreddit, actually. It's reddit.com/r/TomMerritt. It's got our straw poll. It's got the Merritt Militia. It's got a show idea. This is awesome. Who's the mod? Is there a mod? Wiggles! Wiggles the Holy. Thank you. You're the best. This is how it happens.
I want to see a daily because I want it to be like a newspaper.
Right, right. And I guess that's kind of, you've summed up what I was trying to say. Like, it's that kind of idea of a newspaper. You have weekly magazines and you have monthly magazines, but then there's the daily news, right?
Yeah.
Is it possible, and again, this is, I don't know, but I tend to consume my news in what is it, Flipboard?
Flipboard? Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Is it possible to have, like, the show on the Flipboard and then have like the news items like in the show notes and consume it as a newspaper, kind of like a Harry Potter newspaper with you speaking.
Maybe? I wonder if anybody's tried that. I mean, you can have podcasts show up in there.
Right, of course.
Right. Like a Harry Potter.
Yeah.
I mean, that is what tablets are, right? They're the freaking news from Harry Potter with movie pictures. Yep. It's kind of crazy.
Yeah, but when you read it, nowadays it has like different things, and it would be interesting if it was all produced by you kind of thing, though you have like little bits or aggregated. You have the different news stories on it. That would be kind of cool.
This is a crazy idea, but what if a weekly show was also five different daily shows? Did I just blow your mind? Or is it
a little bit? I'm not gonna lie.
I don't know if that really works, though. I don't think that's a news show. I guess that's what I think. Right. You could string together five different shows that hold together as a daily, but you could just subscribe to them individually.
You need your own network.
No.
I know. No, I know. No, I know. No. We've already gone there.
I need that like a hole in the head. You know what? My own network will make me do too many things. I don't want to get sucked in that short news today.
Huh. Eric Duckman says, if it's not 24/7, I ain't watching.
And also, I just want to mention that the only reason I bring that up about your own network is not that I don't love TWiT, like with the everything in my heart.
No, of course not.
That I absolutely love that this thing that has grown from what began from TWiT TV screensavers has exploded into other things. And I think that that's awesome, the way that other people have started and created new things from that. And I just see it growing and growing and growing. That's all that I mean by that, by the way, just for the record.
Tim Barber says, will you pursue sponsors and do you anticipate having any difficulty getting some? We have sponsors for Sword and Laser. So, I there's always difficulty getting sponsors. That is definitely something that certain shows will definitely have and some won't. And I'm not trying to be evasive when I answer this stuff. I just don't know yet. We haven't nailed down all these details. But yeah, sponsors probably, at least in most forms of stuff. Maybe there'll be a Patreon thing where you can get a sponsor-free stuff. I've had the idea of doing Kickstarters where we kickstart 2 months or a month of a show, and then a stretch goal is 2 months commercial free, right? You can just say, like, it'll be commercial free for as long as the funds that we raise can make it, and then we'll have sponsors after that. So, I don't know. I like Patrick. He's like, I just want my daily news with Tom and friends. Doesn't have to be complicated. I'm with you, man. I like that. You're the audience I want. Just give me the stuff. Are you looking to continue to broadcast from your home or creating a studio elsewhere? Really would like to continue to use this for lots of reasons. Oh, I don't know if I stole your idea, Barkley, or if you said it at the same time. Four dailies with a fifth weekly. Four small shows with a long fifth. It's an interesting way to do it. Do a wrap up. All right. Well, I'm not going to – I can tell right now. I thought maybe I could just blow through all of these, but there's just way more even in the Hangout than I can get to. And there's so many in this doc. They're all good questions, but I think I'm going to call it there. Overwhelming, you guys, the response and the willingness to help. I don't know why I deserve it, but I'm glad I do. And I really appreciate the folks who want to support doing good stuff, and I will try to be worthy of that support and belief because I want to do good stuff too.
Tom, can I say quickly that do you have follow-up plans for more of these before you get this going? Because I know that we've got some time between now and the new year, but I think, you know, maybe a follow-up at some point would be a lot of people, you know, particularly towards the end of your term at TWiT, that it would be a great way to kind of launch the next project.
Yeah, I think I'd like to do more than one more of these if I can figure out the timing and everything. So yeah, I think you're right, Jackie. I think it's a great idea. And if nothing else, I'll do one more before the end of the month, and maybe I'll do a few. And like some people said, maybe I'll make some videos where I just kind of hammer out the answers, you know.
Great.
And mix it up. But yeah, that's a big yes. All right. Well, thank you guys for hanging out in the Hangout. You know what I would like to do too, because we were a little gatekeeping on who we could put in here, also partly because we have limited slots. And I might do some stealth Hangouts where I just pop open one of these days and just have a more informal chat with people with the horrible camera on my laptop that you guys saw the other night. It's all backlit and everything. But you know what? It's going to be fine on all sides, on all fronts. It's going to be fine. So I appreciate your help, and I think we can make something amazing and great. And we have seen that happen before with Chat Realm. So I guess that's it. Thank you, Sebastian. Thank you, Patrick. Thank you, Tensor Guy. Hi, May.
No problem.
Thank you, Jackie. Thank you, JC. Thanks to Squirling. Thanks to Chad. Thanks to Brian. For hanging out. Am I missing anybody who was up here? Yeah.
Thanks to T2T2.
Oh, definitely.
The chat room that they put together.
Thanks to T2T2 and SQ Freak and Cheeto for all of the ninja work that has been done out there. I'm sure there's other people involved.
SQ Freak for originally setting up the original chat.
Yeah. I mentioned SQ Freak, definitely.
And thank you, Tom, thank you for allowing us to participate, because I think that, you know, the effort is well deserved. You have created really good stuff over the years, and we feel I've seen you go out of your way to make sure that everybody's appreciated and whatnot, and you know, we really appreciate it, and thanks.
Agreed.
Easy.
Tom, there's always a great dichotomy with you.
Padre SJ like in the that? Chat room too.
Yeah.
I'm holding my phone. I can't do it.
It's too hard. Don't
you're
hurt yourself.
You're doing it inside, Patrick.
We know you're doing it inside.
Tom, right, Is it possible for us to throw out a plug for the T-shirt, or do you?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, please.
Let's do.
Yeah. Do you have that?
Just remember, you can get your Merritt Militia T-shirt. It's at teespring.com/Merritt-Militia.
Do you?
It looks somewhat like this. Oops. There we go.
Somebody have that to throw
in
chat?
Yeah, here we go.
We've gone well beyond. We've got 65 towards our goal of 30. That's amazing.
And then once this is done...
I had nothing to do with this.
We're going to figure out something awesome to get Tom.
Tom didn't either, yeah, of course. But, I obviously, I was thinking, oh, the name Merritt Militia. Oh.
I really like Merritt Militia. But
we are an army, and that. I think that's an acceptable.
Well, a militia.
Before, Jackie, a militia is not an army. A militia is self-organized. It exists outside of the government and authoritative control. Yeah.
And it's voluntary.
A well-ordered militia is an insurance against the dictator turning against you someday.
Oh, God.
So I think it's perfect.
Yes. Good. Because, various members of Chat Realm put this together, and you can go and buy the shirt, and the proceeds are going to go to something for Tom. It may be a Christmas gift. It may just be towards some project that's going to come up in the future. So
yeah, I'd like it to be something that benefits the Merritt Militia, or maybe something that goes on the set or something like
okay.
that.
Okay.
Hey,
but
Aaron,
how much? Okay, so the before we started, we had 64 shirts sold out of the 30 something. So we've gone past the goal. But does somebody have an update on that? Sebastian, you probably. Or
we just sold
Jason?
One more.
Yeah, 65.
Oh well, we have
a militia war chest.
Yes.
You know, Aaron B. put it great. He said militia for peace, and that's kind of what we're trying to do. You know.
Yeah, of course.
We don't want it to feel like it's bashing anybody. You know?
Oh yeah.
No.
Definitely not. We're here to support Tom.
You can't hug a baby with Tyrannosaurus arms. Just saying.
But also, you know, you can buy Lot Beta, Tom's book that's out Amazon. And if you got that email thing that went out, we're going to combine the emails, and it's going to come directly from Tom's site soon. But we were just trying to gather all the support that went out right away and put
that was awesome too.
In one spot. You know, go ahead and sign up wherever you want to sign up, and we'll make sure it's all combined in some way.
Ed wants to know what the best way to get in contact about possible resources is. Did we set that up?
Yeah, there's a link. Yeah. Follow Merritt Militia on Twitter. We'll repost all of those links so that you can get information.
And then we'll come up with the best way to collect all the links for all the things.
There's like 5 or 6 of us that are in the Merritt Militia Twitter thing. So we're watching it nonstop all day. And if you ask that Twitter account a question, then every one of us will respond and send you ways that you can support the future. We're not looking back on the past. We're going towards the future.
We're all Mark McGuire at a steroids hearing right now. I'm not here to talk about the past.
Hey, Tom, Bob McBob has our final question here. He says, will you wear the Merritt Militia T-shirt on your last episode?
No, I won't.
No. That would...
You could have like a TWiT jacket and
I will do all my shows the way I've always done them, with this ridiculous sport coat right here. I don't know. I guess I could wear it quietly.
And then stand up and take off your sport coat at the very end.
And then fly.
I have personally expressed to Leo that you know, with a network the size of TWiT and the way it is, I think that a lot of us certainly understand that decisions need to be made, and there, I don't think any of us really have any hard feelings, you know. I think it's going to be great what's going to happen, because I think that this is just going to expand everything that has already been.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I can't wait.
That was Velvet DePoe, wasn't it?
Yeah. It was. Yes, it was.
I'm very much looking forward to how this thing is going to grow. And
yes, thank you.
And you know, we all bring in a lot of resources and skills, and you know, because we're all tech people in some kind of way. Otherwise, we wouldn't be here. And it's going to be amazing, I think. That's my last thoughts, and I should shut up.
Thank you, guys. It will be amazing. Amazing things will happen, and we'll keep in touch on Twitter at TomMerritt.com, Merritt Militia. Is it .com?
Yes.
Yeah. And that is it for now, because I have to go get some rest and do a show tomorrow. So thank you all for watching. We'll see you later.